ain't got nothing better to do.
Hey, Nat.
Hey, lady. That interview you did with Piper is really selling. Here's your free copy.
See that big blimp? What's the... Brotherhood of Steel. Why are they...
This is Ellie Perkins from Valentine's Detective Agency with a message for Nick's partner. We've got a new case and it sounds urgent. Stop by the office. I'll be waiting. Setting this to repeat.
Stay here.
Selling papers is busy work, lady.
Nat.
Public is here to pull the wool out from under your eyes.
Hey.
What can I do?
Something I can do?
What's on your mind?
How the hell did someone like me luck out and find someone like you?
That was all I had.
Okay.
Don't let the stress of life kill you. Relax, we're still here.
Hey, Valentine.
Where's your son? What happened?
You were right, Nick. Kellogg took my baby. But that wasn't all. He was working with the Institute. He gave them Sean.
The Institute? Oh, boy.
I'm sorry, friend. Truly. That makes things considerably more complicated.
He ain't kidding. Heck, Nick's a synth, and even he doesn't know how to get in.
No synth does. Security protocols strip those memories out.
I need to find a way.
I've been investigating these creeps for over a year now. The Commonwealth's boogeyman. Feared and hated by everyone.
True enough.
Sometimes they snatch people in the middle of the night, and sometimes they leave old synths behind to remind us that they're out there. But to this day, there's one thing nobody really knows.
Where the Institute actually is, or how to get in.
Exactly. But there's one person who has to know, right? The guy who just handed them Sean.
Kellogg? Huh.
You read my mind. He had to have a way in and out.
Yeah, but something tells me he's not gonna drop by for a chat and coffee.
He's dead, Nick.
So, a murderer and a kidnapper gets his brains blown out by an avenging parent. Huh. Be a great ending if we didn't still have the biggest mystery in the Commonwealth to solve.
Doesn't matter what he knew. I'd kill him again in a heartbeat.
Gets his brains blown out. Huh. His brains. You know, we may not need the man at all.
You're talking crazy here, Nick. Got a fault in the old subroutines?
Look, there's a place in Good Neighbor called the Memory Den. Relive the past moments in your mind as clear as the day they happened. If anyone could get a dead brain to sing, it'll be Dr. Amari, the mind behind the memories.
Who's this Dr. Amari?
I'll let her give you her life story in person. Let's stay focused. I guess we're gonna need a piece of Kellogg's brain. Enough gray matter to bring to Amari and find out if this is going to work.
Jesus, Nick! Gross! Seriously?
I know it's grisly, but what choice do we have? We got no leads, nothing. That old merc's brain just might have all the secrets we need to know.
What exactly do we need, Nick?
Kellogg's brain. It's a long shot, but Dr. Amari just might be able to get it jump-started. See what the old merc knew.
Actually, I think I already have something. Kellogg had this thing attached to his head.
Cybernetics, huh? We may have just won the lottery.
Whether we're riding this crazy brain train or not, we can't all go running across the Commonwealth, so who's coming with you?
I have to go to the Memory Den either way, if I'm going to introduce you to Amari. But if you want to head there together, just say so.
I'll head out with Piper. We'll meet you there, Nick.
Sounds good. You two stay out of trouble. Don't worry. We're gonna get your boy back. Just a few more steps.
Ellie.
I'm glad you're here. We got a new case while you and Nick were out. Ready to put on the detective hat?
Who's our client?
A fisherman, whose family lives on the edge of the Commonwealth. Kenji Nakano.
Nakano? Huh. That name takes me back. My memory's a little fuzzy on the details, though.
Maybe if you bothered writing things down, Nick.
Can't do that. Wouldn't want to put you out of a job.
Huh. I'll remember that the next time you need me to console a hysterical client. Mr. Nakano didn't leave many details. Said he'd go over everything when you meet him. But if you want my guess, missing person case. Guy had a worried look a mile long.
Anything you can tell me about Kenji Nakano?
Just some impressions. He was obviously upset, but he was also in a hurry. Like, he couldn't stand just waiting around. I'm a friend of Nick's. He'll remember me. I need his help right away. And then he was gone. He was muttering something on the way out, but... no. I'm not sure it was important.
Come on, Ellie. Don't hold out on me. What did he say?
Well, I thought I heard him say something about his daughter and also a radio, but I might have misheard him. Not sure how the two would be connected.
I'll go check it out. Thanks, Ellie.
The Nakano residence is up in the northeast, near the coast. A small fishing house. He said that he and his wife will be waiting for you.
It's a long walk. That's how the hard cases always start.
You look a little roughed up. Should talk to Doc Crocker over at Mega Surgery.
Your lips. Maybe make them fuller, softer. Shrink your nose. Taper your ears. Simple surgery. Quick and painless.
Sounds good.
Thank you for taking this journey with me. Just sit down in the chair there. a bit of a nip, a bit of a tuck, and a small payment is all you need for a new face.
Hey, I'll be right back. Excuse me, you got a moment? Do you feel like Diamond City leadership has been responsive?
Hey there. I got an empty chair here just waiting for some beautiful customer to get a haircut.
Just bother someone else.
Yeah, sure. Thanks for stopping this time.
What are my options?
You name it. Shaves, long cuts, short cuts, braids, layering. Yeah, be easier just to show you. Got an empty chair right here.
That'd be great.
Maybe a new color, huh? Sit down. Let's take a look.
Everyone who's anyone reads public occurrences. Thank you.
You look terrible. Have my boy John straighten that mess on your head.
What are you saying? Yes.
Do all you outsiders wear such funny clothes?
Head on inside.
You need something, Scabber?
Thank you.
Right back here. Hurry!
Hey! I told you to bring him in through the basement!
Ooh,
shut up!
I don't like
they're headed this way now. Be ready. Taking so long.
I don't know. Maybe you should go check it out.
You don't think I will?
I'm tired of sitting on my ass anyway.
What's the point of hiding back here? Why the hell don't we?
What?
Normal for other journalists.
Excellent.
last one we tried to pull in? With all the grenades?
I was out doing my rounds. At the bottom.
Well, Becca pulled him into the front of the store, and everything seemed fine, right? He must have got spooked or something, because he suddenly starts throwing grenades everywhere.
What?
What did I do? That's the thing. It turns out they weren't grenades at all. They were just rocks. He was making the sound of his mouth. Pins being pulled all 9 yards.
That's fucking nuts.
No, we just stood there. We couldn't believe what we were seeing. After he threw about a half a dozen rocks near the back of the store, he started making machine gun noises and backed into the door. Once he got outside, it sounded like he pretended to get on a motorcycle, which of course didn't start right away. Then he took off toward the freeway and went south.
Full throttle.
Looking for? We have everything.
Working hard?
You're back. You find that paint?
Wasn't easy, but I found some, yeah.
Now that's damn fine news. Why don't you go ahead and paint the first stroke? Let's see how the shade matches up.
Abbott.
That's a good shade of green. The wall sure seems happy with it.
You think that's enough paint to last you?
Should be enough for a good coat or two. That'll have to do for now. There's your payment, and a little bonus for getting the right shade of green. Don't do anything with it I wouldn't do.
I'm glad we did this. The wall is important to a lot of people here, Blue.
You didn't run into any trouble getting here. Bridge across the river. Super.
Ah!
Farming's as honest as honest.
You looking for something to wear? Sweet.
Can't keep you out.
Farm's not much.
Step right
but
up.
But it's something. All the clothing fit to wear.
Let's see what you got.
Great. If you work, you eat. It's as simple as that. Hey,
just let me know. Help yourself.